Welcome once again to the Hi-Fi Club. It's nice to have you with us.
The story of Australian television can't be told without Bert Newton.
Oh, I'm so pleased. It's Bert Newton.
He was there from television's very beginning, playing straight man to Graham Kennedy and sidekick to Don Lane.
Please stick me somewhere, will you?
I'll stick you somewhere.
But it was clear Bert was a star in his own right, custom built for an age when TV needed to be all things for all people. For decades, Bert was a mainstay of Australian television, winning over multiple generations of fans. In the early 90s, he became the host of Good Morning Australia, taking a medium designed for horoscopes and vacuum cleaner advertorials and turning it into appointment viewing with his razor-sharp wit.
Oh, no, you don't have to do that, Jan. You were coming back to the show anyway.
There were countless strings to his bow. He was a singer, an actor. He hosted the Logie Awards 19 times and won the gold 4 times. He felt like a presence that would be with us forever.
I would like him to be remembered as the legend that he was. The outpour of love has been fabulous.
As news of his death broke, social media was awash with tributes from friends, colleagues and fans.
This is such sad news for any Australian. Bert Newton was the ultimate entertainer.
He was an icon, a true professional and a true gent.
A state funeral will be held in Melbourne. Bert leaves behind his wife Patty, 2 children, 6 grandchildren and a legacy of entertainment that will never be equalled.
Well, here with us to talk about the great man is none other than Rove McManus. Rove, this is such incredibly sad news. What did Bert mean to you?
Well, Bert, for me, he was one of those people that was just a stalwart of the industry for anyone who does what we do, what I do in particular. He was the guy who started it all with Graham Kennedy. He'd been on television since it began in this country, pretty much. So when I first started at 10... he was this looming figure that I hoped would welcome me into the fold. But when we first got to meet, I was fully prepared for him to be very standoffish as the old dog in the yard and kick me aside. But because he's Bert Newton, he'd earned that right. But he wasn't. He was just so welcoming and over the years would give me advice, became a bit of a mentor, and that became a very strong friendship that lasted till both of us were finished full-time at 10. So when I heard the news yesterday, as much as it wasn't a huge surprise, it was still a very sad shock.
Rove, on that note of his generosity, the persistent theme in all the social media tributes that we've seen over the last 16 hours or so was just how generous he was. That was my experience on a couple of occasions when I was on Bert's show. But always with up-and-coming performers, he made them feel welcome, like there was lots of room in the sandpit. How important was boosting new talent to Bert?
It was huge, and again, not something that you would necessarily expect from a more established act from a previous generation. Even when we did the Boxing Day Tsunami telethon, and it was across all 3 networks, and everybody was looking for a representative host for each of the networks, and Channel 10 came to me and I said, well, I shouldn't be doing this, it should be Bert. To me, he's the face of the network. And they said, he doesn't want to do it, he said it should be you. That's a huge deal. It was a very important telecast, a historic telecast, and it wasn't like he wasn't available. We kissed that night, so he was very much in the room. But very happy to step aside and let the new talent come through and also plant a kiss on them as well. So very giving in many different ways, Lisa.
Well, have you guys... have a lot of history. He's obviously very, very close to you. What have we lost?
Oh, boy. We have lost an era, an epoch of how television and entertaining is done. He was an all-rounder, old-school singer, dancer, host, and you don't really get that anymore. And I dare say that we really will never see the likes of Bert Newton ever again. You do say, oh, that there are very big shoes to fill when someone like him is gone, but I dare say that the shoes are gone as well. There is nothing to be filled anymore. It's like there's been a line in the sand. That's it now with him no longer with us, which is a very, very sad thought in many ways.
It is indeed. Rove, good to talk as always. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. Wonderful to share some memories.